Now we recall the day on which he was presented in the temple, when he was offered to the Father and shown to his people. As a sign of his coming among us, his mother was purified, as we now come to him for cleansing. In their old age, Simeon and Anna recognized him as their Lord, as today we sing of his glory. In this Eucharist, we celebrate both the joy of his coming and his searching judgment, looking back to the day of his birth and forward to the coming days of his passion. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray that we may know and share the light of Christ. Almighty and ever-living God, clothed in majesty, whose beloved Son was this day presented in the temple in substance of our flesh, grant that we may be presented to you with pure and clean hearts by your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Would you please be seated for our reading?
A reading from Malachi. See, I am sending my messenger to prepare the way before me, and the Lord whom you seek will suddenly come to his temple. The messenger of the covenant in whom you delight. Indeed, he is coming, says the Lord of hosts. But who can endure the day of his coming, and who can stand when he appears? For he is like a refiner's fire, and like fuller's soap. He will sit as a refiner and purifier of silver, and he will purify the descendants of Levi and refine them like gold and silver until they present offerings to the Lord in righteousness. Then the offering of Judea and Jerusalem will be pleasing to the Lord as in the days of old and in former years. Then I will draw near to you for judgment. I will be swift to bear witness against the sorcerers, against the adulterers, against those who swear falsely, against those who oppress the hired workers in their wages, the widow and the orphan, against those who thrust aside the alien and do not fear me, says the Lord of hosts. This is the word of the Lord.
Psalm 24. Lift up your heads, O gates. Be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in.
Who is the King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty. The Lord who is mighty in battle.
Lift up your heads, O gates. Be lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in.
Who is the King of glory? The Lord of hosts, he is the King of glory. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
The second reading is taken from Hebrews. Since therefore the children share flesh and blood, he himself likewise shared the same things, so that through death he might destroy the one who has the power of death, that is, the devil, and free those who all their lives were held in slavery by the fear of death. For it is clear that he did not come to help angels, but the descendants of Abraham. Therefore, he had to become like his brothers and his sisters in every respect, so that he might be a merciful and faithful high priest in the service of God, to make a sacrifice of atonement for the sins of the people. Because he himself was tested by what he suffered, he is able to help those who are being tested. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Today the Lord is presented in the temple in substance of our mortal nature.
Amen.
Today the Blessed Virgin comes to be purified in accordance with the law.
Amen.
Today old Simeon proclaims Christ as the light of the nations and the glory of Israel.
Amen.
Praise to Christ, the light of the world.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the time came for their purification according to the law of Moses, Mary and Joseph brought Jesus up to Jerusalem to present him to the Lord, as it is written in the law of the Lord. Every firstborn male shall be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves, or two young pigeons. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus, to do for him what was customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and the rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was also a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel of the tribe of Asher. She was of a great age, having lived with her husband for 7 years after her marriage, then as a widow to the age of 84. She never left the temple but worshipped there with fasting and prayer night and day. At that moment she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for the redemption of Jerusalem. When they had finished everything required by the law of the Lord, they returned to Galilee to their own town of Nazareth. The child grew and became strong, filled with wisdom, and the favour of God was upon him. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. The events recorded in Luke's Gospel surrounding Christ's presentation in the temple are a reminder that Jesus was born and lived under the law. Indeed, we can see that he is the fulfillment of prophets, both of which appear in this very act of the presentation and Simeon's prophecy. According to the law, a newborn Jewish boy would be circumcised on the eighth day, and then, in accordance with Leviticus chapter 12, a woman was to be presented for purification by sacrifice 33 days after the boy's circumcision. And that brings us neatly to 40 days. Numbers often have layers of significance in the Bible. And so whenever we hear 40, we are of course hearing echoes of the 40 years the Israelites spent walking in the wilderness during Exodus, and the 40 days and 40 nights Jesus spent in the wilderness after his baptism. And for the church, these 40 days mark the end of the Christmas season. Some people have only just taken down their Christmas tree, because some people wait all the way through to Candlemas to take it down. It does effectively end Christmas. And this feast day became known as Candlemas. The gospel reading includes a beautiful hymn of praise by Simeon, the Nunc Dimittis, as he praises God for Jesus, the light of the world. And this led people to bring their candles to church to be blessed. So it became known as Candlemas. And in the first years of the church, worship was often at night, and candles and torches were carried from place to place within the worship space as needed. And candles were also a mark of festivity and hospitality when people gathered for prayer in their homes. And then later on in large buildings with thick walls and dark corners. Even after the arrival of gas light and electric light bulbs, candles were kept, because there is something beautiful, warm and clean about the light of a candle flame. But candles are also a sign of the partnership between God and creation. The wax made by bees, gathered and fashioned by human hands into something beautiful and useful. In order for light to shine, the candle surrenders itself. It pours itself out so that light can flood into the world. It's a sense of, it's a great word, kenosis, a sense of outpouring of self that we too are called to as Christians. And the candle of baptism or confirmation placed in our hands speaks silently of that same wisdom. If you would save your life, you must lose it. You must pour your life out like Christ, so that you are filled with the light of his love. But sitting behind these lovely traditions, there is a really moving encounter between two new parents and two old faithful servants of the Lord, Simeon and Anna. Simeon looked into the face of Jesus and saw the light to enlighten the Gentiles and the glory of his people Israel. And even amongst this joy, Luke remains at pains to point out the cost of this gift. And the theme of sacrifice in the presentation is actually first found in the parents, who are almost background figures in this passage. Mary and Joseph come to the temple with a pair of young pigeons required for the sacrifice of the purification. In Leviticus, we're told that new parents should bring a lamb and a turtle dove. But if they could not afford a sheep, then two pigeons would be acceptable. It's a tiny detail, but it reminds us that Jesus was not born into great wealth and power. Mary and Joseph were bringing the poorer sacrifice. And Simeon, waiting for the Messiah, might have expected a powerful soldier or a politician, or even the newborn child of a king. But no, the child is that of a humble couple. But Simeon recognizes his Lord all the same. And then the second figure, Anna, the prophet. Prayer in the temple was the focus of her whole life. She was a holy woman, old in years, and using all of her remaining energy on communion with God. And at the moment described in Luke's Gospel, Anna steps forward and, overcome with sublime joy, begins praising God for what has happened. The Greek word used suggests the idea of recognition. She sees what others cannot. And her reaction is immediate and dramatic. She speaks in as loud a voice as she can muster, telling anybody that will listen that this is an extraordinary child. Here, in front of their eyes, is the one who will bring redemption to Israel. Some people feel that as they grow older, they have less to offer society or their family or the church, and it just isn't true. Simeon and Anna are wonderful examples of older members of their community who were faithful and steadfast, modeling the life of faith. Because they prayed all the time, they were deeply rooted in God, and this gave them wisdom. Their hearts and their minds were open to seeing the Messiah when he came to them, even in the most unexpected of ways. And their words in proclaiming Christ opened the eyes of others and gave Mary and Joseph much to ponder. But above all, they were humble servants of the Lord. We see them only for a moment as they point the way to Jesus, and then, their task fulfilled, they depart in peace. Let us be Anna's and Simeon's. Let us continue to grow in faith and wisdom. And when the opportunities come, let us point others to the light of Christ in all that we do. Amen.
Is our light and life. Father, your Christ is acclaimed as the glory of Israel. Look in mercy on your church, sharing his light. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Father, your Christ in his temple brings judgment on the world. Look in mercy on the nations who long for his justice. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Father, your Christ who was rich, for our sakes became poor. Look in mercy on the needy, suffering with him. Lord, in mercy on the departed, especially Bob Isted, Bridget Hollywood, and May Campbell, that they may see your salvation. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Father, your Christ is revealed as the one destined to be rejected. Look in mercy on us who now turn towards his passion. Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord God, you kept faith with Simeon and Anna and showed them the infant king. Give us grace to put all our trust in your promises and the patience to wait for their fulfillment. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Hear the words of our Saviour Jesus Christ. I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me shall never walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. Let us therefore bring our sins into his light and confess them in penitence and faith. Let us confess our sins. Father eternal, giver of light and grace, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in what we have thought, in what we have said and done, through ignorance, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We have wounded your love and marred your image in us. We are sorry and ashamed and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past and lead us out from darkness to walk as children of light. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
In the tender mercy of our God, the dayspring from on high has broken upon us to give light to those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We offer one another a sign of peace. Thank you. come near to us in judgment. He searches the hearts of all your people and brings to light the image of your splendor. Your servant Simeon acclaimed him as the light to lighten the nations, while Anna spoke of him to all who looked for your redemption. Destined for the falling and rising of many, he was lifted high upon the cross, and a sword of sorrow pierced his mother's heart when by his sacrifice he made our peace with you. And now we rejoice and glorify your name, that we too have seen your salvation, and join with angels and archangels in their unending hymn of praise.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of heaven and earth, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world,
Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen.
that eternal city where you live and reign, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. I invite you to follow the cross procession to the font. We say together the Nunc Dimittis.
Now, Lord, you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.
Father, here we bring to an end our celebration of the Saviour's birth.
Help us in the room he has been born, to live his life as the end.
Here we have offered the Church's sacrifice of praise.
Help us to receive the bread of life, to be thankful for your gift.
Here we have rejoiced with faithful Simeon and Anna.
Help us to have found the Lord in this temple, to trust in your eternal promises.
Here we have greeted the light of the world.
Help us to extinguish these candles, never to forsake the light of Christ.
Here we stand near the place of baptism.
Help us through our heart with the cross to share the Lord's death and resurrection.
Here we turn from Christ's birth to his passion.
Help us for whom Lent is here to enter deeply into the Easter mystery.
Here we bless one another in your name.
Help us in our own peace to shine with your light in the world. Thanks be to God. Amen.
I invite you to take the candles with you to light your way home.